Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Job. This is Rupesh Jadhav. Today I have come with some different concept of presenting the information about geography in front of you. It is somewhat an MCQ form, so please watch it till end, okay? And if you have not subscribed to my channel Wisdom Jobs, please subscribe it and also give like, comment and share this video. And let me tell you, this video is very much helpful for the student who are preparing for 10th, 12th, graduation level, school level also, and for various competitive exams. And it will clear your concept all about the various terminologies used in geography in various ways. Okay, so please watch it till end. So let's start with some different concept. Okay, so I have taken the question from this. Okay, a narrow channel of sea, okay, of sea, which separates two land masses, two land masses, okay, is known as. So the option is mound, pass, strait or valley. Okay, so in your opinion, what it might be? Because here some keywords are given. Firstly, the keyword is sea, okay, so somewhat sea, and two land mass. It simply means there are two land mass, and in between this is land one and this is land two, and in between there is sea. Okay, so this is sea. So what it might be? Is it a mound or is it a pass? Is it a strait or is it a valley? Exactly which one is it? Okay, this or this. So let's start. Now I will have to go through each and every concept. I am going through each and every concept so that the idea for this, why the answer is that one and why the answer is why the others are not. So in that way it will clear your concept. Okay, so let's go for the answer. Let's check out what is the answer. So firstly, I have written that why not mound? Okay, why not mound? So is the mound answer or not? Option A. Okay, option A, the mound, whether it is the answer or not. Okay, now what is mound exactly? I have taken the picture from Wikipedia. Okay, so check it out. It is not a hill, it is not a mountain, though it seems to be a hill and mountain. Here is small home and some nearby this. Okay, so it is a heaped pile. Heaped pile means everything which is collected there, heaped up, okay, in that way, of sand, gravel, debris, earth or rocks generally. Okay, it is a heaped of, it may be heaped of a sand along with gravels, some debris, some earth and rocks. That is known as mound. This is the definition of the mound. Okay, now here the definition itself is clear. That our question was what? What is that called between land 1 and land 2 having narrow sea? So there is no such word like sea. There is no such word like land. They have mentioned the heaped pile. Okay, so heaped pile along with rock and sand. So the keyword sea is missing here. Okay, so here the definition itself says that it is not, the answer is not a mound for that question. It sometimes include mountain and hills. So mountain and hills have different type of definitions, somewhat regarding the height. Height from the mean sea level is given. Okay, so topographically it is a rounded area of higher elevation. Okay, so you can see that it is of higher elevation than the surrounding one. Here there is a house. Okay, there is a fence and it is elevated. Okay, now which are the different types of mounds? So first one is the subglacial mounds. Now word itself says subglacial, so it is related with somewhat glacier. Okay, and subglacial. Okay, so it is a subglacial is mound is a natural mound. It is caused by erupting lava. Okay, trapped beneath an ice sheet or glacier. Let's consider that this is, okay, this is what? The ice glacier. Okay, and the lava which is coming out from the vent, it get trapped here. That causes this vertical ice sheet to rise. Okay, this lava make it rise. Okay, and that causes this rise. Okay, so it is trapped beneath, then this is ice sheet, so this is ice, and here it is somewhat that lava which has been trapped between this ice sheet, giving it the shape of a mount. Now subglacial, if this had been not there, the sub word has been not present there, so it might be glacial mount, something like that. Okay, so the example we have Iceland, Antarctica and British Columbia, that is in Canada, the state of Canada, British Columbia. We have there the subglacial, that is natural one. Okay, now coming to the next. So burial mound itself, the burial word itself says that it is an artificial man-made. Okay, so that cremate, the generally we bury some dead person there in that way, or you can say that like somewhat pyramid, but not exactly pyramid, but constructed in that way. So okay, that is artificial mound. And third one is the platform mounds. So again, it is artificial. Here the word is platform. So here the sacred acts, rituals, then secular functions are done, speeches, everything are done, given through that. Okay, so that type of mound. So here our answer is not a mound, because we need, our keywords are sea and two land masses. So it is not where anyway. Okay, next point we will see. Okay, so now passes. So now why not passes? I have given the heading. Why not passes is also, so it makes clear that passes is also not the answer. Okay, pass is a gap or break. Pass is a gap, somewhat gap or break. Now you will say that two land masses are there and there is gap. Okay, but don't forget the presence of sea, land one, land two. So the sea is also present there. Gap or break in high. Now that is the thing. This may be high. Okay, rugged. This may be rugged. Okay, terrain, rugged terrain such as mountain. Okay, this can be considered that it is a mountain one and this is mountain two, and here the sea is that. Okay, mountain ridge. Okay, now this is the thing. Now such as mountain ridge, it simply says that there is a mountain, there is a mountain. Okay, so let's consider this as a mountain, and this is what the pass means. This is mountain, a single mountain, but this has been eroded. It might be eroding due to vertical erosional act of river, or might be glacier, and it is giving the, it is somewhat a gap created here, or the mountain seems to be broken. So again, here itself it is clear that landmass and sea, the sea is needed here, though it is not present. Okay, so it forms when a glacier or a stream erodes or wears away. It might be eroded. Earlier, this part might be like this. Okay, this is mountain. Now what happened here? It has been eroded. Okay, and this part has eroded. This part might be eroded by glacier or a stream, or wears away the land between areas of higher terrain. So this is, this seems to be. Now if I am going to check out, so it again is big, if I am going to check out this one. Okay, so it is higher here, from here, this point you are going to enter this, because it becomes like this. Okay, so the original level which has been eroded by stream, the erosional activity might be vertical in direction. Okay, or the glaciers which are coming down through these slopes. Okay, and if a person wants to cross this, he don't have to cross. Means now let's check out, if this is not there, if this is not there, anyone who wants to go there, he will have to cross this and then go back. Means now consider this as a mountain, and at this place there is a gap. Okay, sorry, pass, that gap. Okay, if this is not there, I will have to climb this much height and then go to that side, then go after this bird, but now I can cross it from this level. So I don't have to go to this height, I will go to this height and then I can go on the other side. Okay, it provides the easiest routes for people to travel across the steep mountain ranges, for example Himalaya. For example, Jozila, Burzila in J&K, Bara Lapchala, Nitila, Lipu Lake in Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, there are such passes. Nathula, you might have heard, okay, then that those are the passes. So if that it is not present there, if it is not present there, you have to climb so much distance to get and connect with that other part. Okay, so you might have heard about that Leh Ladakh Road, National Highway, Srinagar Leh Road. During the winter season, it gets closed due to the iceberg. If that simply means if snow covered is there, the connectivity with that other part gate is not there, it get disconnected. Okay, so that Leh Ladakh or Srinagar Leh Road, that is very much important. Every year it is get covered by snow. Okay, this is the mountain, this is the mountain slope. This slope which you see, it has been eroded. This is here somewhat is the river channel. Okay, so it has been eroded by the river stream. Sometime here you can see that there are snow, it is snow covered, so it is coming down and it is making the way. If it is not there, imagine that this peak ridge and the ridge over this point is same, the person, it is very hard to cross. This makes the transportation route very much easily. Okay, there is a route easy. Okay, in this way, in this way, and moreover the river is flowing in this part. Okay, this is the river flowing in that region. Okay, so it clears your picture that this is what we say pass. Okay, this is pass. Then coming to the next, now why not valley? Again the same thing. Option was, you might be knowing that the question, again you are forgetting the question. The question is, what is the narrower part which connects the two land masses and it is connected by means of a sea? This is the question, keep it in mind. First we have seen mound, second we have seen what passes. Now third option is that of valley. Okay, so let's come back again to the valley. Why not? The answer is valley. The valley is a hollow or surface depression. Now it is a depression, again depression of the earth bounded by hills. It is bounded by hills. So somewhat how it is arrangement. Okay, so earlier it was like this. Now here the depression forms, here the depression forms between hills or mountains. Okay, this is hill 1 and this is hill 2. So here the depression is getting formed. Okay, surface depression, sorry, not depression only, surface depression, the surface gate depression here in this part. Okay, a natural trough or a natural trough, the earth surface. Okay, if you have gone through the Indian map, you might be knowing that there is here there is Vindhya and here there is Narmada and here there is Satpura. Vindhya, Satpura and Narmada. So it has, here there is trough, this is part, Narmada river flows through the trough. Okay, that slopes down to a stream. So here the stream or lake or the ocean formed by water or ice erosion, it has formed due to the act of water, a stream or an ice erosion. Okay, if glacier is coming down in that way, this part has formed. Okay, now second part. So what are the types of valleys? What are the types of valleys? The V valley is caused by the forces such as erosion and river. Now consider that this is a mountain slope. Here it is V valley formed and here again it is mountain slope. So it seems that it is a V valley. Okay, here you have to keep it in mind that earlier the river might be flowing at this level. Then due to vertical erosion activity of the river or the stream, it is eroding, it is eroding, it is eroding, it is eroding, and finally we get this type of V-shaped valley. Okay, so it is caused by the forces such as erosion and rivers. Okay, then U-shaped valley. Now let's go to the other point. It is formed by the huge bodies of ice that moved along. They carved the valleys as they passed, carrying away the giant boulders and huge amount of debris. Okay, so now imagine that at this point there are ice. Okay, that is glacier, it is coming down, it is coming down, so they will erode step by step. Okay, exactly it is not U-shaped, but it seems finally to be of that U-shaped. Okay, so this is U-shaped valley. Okay, so this valley, this is earlier V-shaped, now this is U-shaped valley.
So remember, U-shaped valley, the ice or snow is must. Okay,
So that gives the final shape, that is U-shaped valley. Okay, now in V-shaped valley there was vertical erosion. Okay, but in U-shaped valley there will be, along with vertical, there will be horizontal erosion. So horizontal erosion activity is also there, which widens the original V-shaped valley. This is V-shaped valley. It gets widened by means of this U-shaped valley in this way. Okay, earlier it was like this. Let me show you. Okay, earlier it was like this V shape. So here the stream is eroding this part, and vertical erosion is going on. But later on, this, along with vertical erosion, lateral erosion is also there by means of a ice which is falling, glacier which is coming down this through this slope, and this widen the valley, like giving it a U shape. Earlier V shape, now it is U shape. Okay, so and the slope is very much steep, you can see that. Okay, now coming to the next, that is flat floor valley. Flat floor valley are formed by the streams, but they are usually older, more developed. Okay, now what happened? Let's consider that this is V shape valley, it get changes to U shape valley. Then afterward it will acquire the shape like a flat shape valley, or might be like this. Okay, so this is V shape, U shape, and this is flat floored. Okay, here it is still getting widened, here it is widening, it gets more widened, and we have the valley floor. This is valley floor, which is flat. Okay, stream channel becomes smooth. Here the stream's channel becomes smooth and begins smooth the steep V or U-shaped valley. The valley floor gets more wider than this. So again, this was valley, but our question was what? Our question was, which is that part which connects two land masses, and in that between there is narrow sea channel. Okay, narrow sea is there and two land masses are there. So here we don't find any sea, we don't find any what we say, two land masses. The land masses, you can say that this is the one, but this is the, I will like to tell you, it is, those are not two mountains. This is the same mountain, okay, in which the valley is formed, and the word uses stream, river, that one. So it is also not our answer. The valley is not our answer. Now let's go to the next part. So this is our answer. So again, the question was, शायद आप लोग भूल गए होंगे यहां तक आने तक के. सो लेट मी टेल यू, द क्वेश्चन वॉज अ नैरो चैनल ऑफ सी विच सेपरेट्स टू लैंड मासेस. व्हाट इज दैट? ओके, अ नैरो चैनल ऑफ सी विच सेपरेट्स टू लैंड मासेस. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज सी, स्ट्रेट. सो लेट्स चेक, अ स्ट्रेट इज नेचुरली फॉर्म्ड. ओके, नैरो टिपिकली नेविगेबल वॉटरवे. सो आवर क्वेश्चन वॉज दिस आर नैरो चैनल ऑफ सी विच सेपरेट्स टू लैंड मासेस. तो लैंड मास नंबर वन, लैंड मास नंबर टू. ओके, टू लैंड मासेस दैट कनेक्ट्स टू लार्जर बॉडीज, टू लार्जर बॉडीज, बॉडी वन बॉडी टू. ओके, एंड हियर इट इज नैरो सी. ओके, सो टू लैंड मासेस, लैंड वन लैंड टू. So this is what the thing. So land mass, land one, land two. So C is that answer actually. For example, here I have taken the figure of that Palk Strait. Can you see here? It is somewhat this. This is India, this is Sri Lanka, and in between this is Palk Strait. Okay, so here land mass, and this one becomes Palk Strait. Okay. So this side Bay of Bengal, this side Indian Ocean. So Indian Ocean on this side, Bay of Bengal in this side. Okay, so this is our proper answer. So straight. You have enjoyed this video. Please give like and also put the comment in comment box, and also share this video to your friends. So this was all about the strait, mound, then valleys, glaciers. Then I said that about various position of sun with respect to earth. Okay, hope your ideas might got clear. And let me tell you, if you have not subscribed our channel Wisdom Jobs, please subscribe it, and give like, comment and share to this video. Okay. So thanks for watching Wisdom Jobs. Please subscribe it. Thank you.